చిత్రించబడిన దాని పవిత్ర చరిత్ర మన దేశానికి సత్కీర్తిని సంపూర్చు ఉత్తమ కృషి సల్పడానికి మనకు ప్రోత్సాహప్రదాలు లభిస్తున్నాయి. మన జాతీయ పతాకం పట్ల అచంచల విశ్వాసాన్ని వ్యక్తీకరిస్తూ మనం అక్షరాల తత్ప్రధాన గామలమని మనలో ప్రతి ఒక్కరము దాని ప్రాభవ వైభవాలను ఇతోధికం చేయడానికి అనువైన అవిరళ కృషి చేసి సభ్య దేశాలలో సగర్వంగా సమృద్ధంగా అది ఎగిరేటట్లుగా చేస్తామని ప్రకటిస్తున్నాము.
Thank you, Lakshmi. Now I request line Dr. A.S. Durga Prasad. Swagatopanyasam cheyavalasindiga korchunna.
Thank you, Nageshwar Rao. Very, very good evening to you all. Chief guest of the day, past multiple council chairman garu Prakash Rao garu. Mariyu vichesina andar sabhyulu. Ee naati mana resource person Dr. Archana Gambani. Now we all know what physiotherapy is, but you know, this has come into prominence only for the last 1.5 decades. I mean, even people who wanted to get into education, it has assumed importance only in the last 1.5 decades. Prior to that, this was confined to very, very few activities. Now, like what happened to dental faculty, physiotherapy also has become a very good faculty for people to join. Basically, physiotherapists are the experts who in movement and function help in partnership with the patients, and they also can help in preventing further injury by listening to the patient. This is my personal experience. Even when I went in for a low back problem, the way I was treated by the physiotherapist who advised me was tremendous, and I think in the last 14-15 years I never had any problem. Except when again I got into a knee problem, I went to the doctor and he suggested certain exercises. But I was sharing with Archana, the impact was not much. Probably I had to confess, I probably have not followed the instructions that have been given by them. But otherwise, I think if you do physiotherapy in a proper way, as per the advice, I'm sure the results could be good. What actually these physiotherapists do is they educate us, they show us the modalities of doing it. They show us therapeutic exercises. They advise us and re-educate us on the muscles. They also help us in joint manipulation and mobilization. They show us breathing exercises. They also help us in soft tissue mobilization, hydrotherapy. I can go on. There are almost about 15-20 activities which they help us in this. And physiotherapy today is a degree. Based on it's a degree based profession, not like in the past where it used to be a licentiate or a certificate course. And physiotherapists have wide range of skills who assess and diagnose and treat different conditions like low back pain, subacromial impingement, sports injuries, which is very, very common. We hear that every sports team that there is a physiotherapist who accompanies that team. And then they also help us in neurological, strokes, spinal cord problems, injuries, Parkinson's, multiple scenarios, and also during the cardiovascular treatment, they help us in rehabilitation after the heart attack or after the surgeries. So there are multiple ways by which physiotherapists are doing. There are a good number of physiotherapists who help both at the hospital level. Each hospital is again having a physiotherapy club, as well as individual clinics are there. There are lots of instruments have come into place which are helping us. So what we thought at Shatabdi Club, we began with COVID-19 program, and fortunately Mr. Prakash Rao was the chief guest for that too. And then from COVID-19 we took the next step of doing a program on diabetic management. Then we did a program on nutrition, which again some of the tips related to COVID also had been given. And this is the fourth program related to similar subject, not exactly related to COVID, but definitely we can relate, because I think all of us are hooked up at home for the last 5 months, which not much of a physical activity. And because of the advice of the doctors, especially with people with morbid conditions like diabetes and hypertension, we have been advised not to move out of the house. So we have confined ourselves even in exercising at home. So I'm very happy that we have Archana today with us, and I will very briefly introduce before I hand it over to Nageshwar Rao and to Mr. Prakash Rao. Dr. Archana Gambani, she's a graduate with BSc physiotherapy from St. GS Medical College. She worked in the cerebral palsy unit of Children's Orthopedic Hospital. Then she also worked with in the physiotherapy department, orthopedic department of neurology, cardiorespiratory place, gynecology and plastic surgery departments. Worked in physiotherapy, orthopedic neurology, cardiotherapy departments of Bommanji Dinsha Petit Parsi General Hospital. Post August 1998, Dr. Gambani has been freelancing. She conducts home visits for patients with physiological ailments, and she is a completed. She has completed a yoga certification level 1 course offered by Morarji Desai National Institute of Yoga. And here also, I would like to acknowledge that Archana has been introduced to us again by my niece Uma from Mumbai. And again, once again, a hearty welcome to you all. Over to Nageshwar.
Thank you very much, Lion Dr. Durga Prasad, DNRT, Mukhya Atithi, past District Governor, District 320D, past multiple council chairperson, vast knowledge on 20 Vyakti, Maku, Chirakala Mitrulu in 20, Lion Doctor, Prakash Rao Garni, Matladal Sindhika Kurchuna.
Yeah. So, presiding officer, president of Shatabdi Lions Club, Dr. Durga Prasad Garu, Charter President, my good friend, Lion Peri Nageshwar Rao Garu, and all the Lion friends, Shatabdi Club and other sister clubs, and even other friends also, other than Lions, who are present here. So first of all, it's a wonderful moment here to join with all of you, particularly especially good friends of Shatabdi Lions. I hope if we take this slide away, we can in front of us, everybody, I think, mostly.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, all of. Archana, can you minimize this?
Yeah, just a minute. I have to minimize this. 1 minute.
You have to press escape.
Yeah, 1 minute.
Yeah, okay. I just have to go.
Yes, yeah, very, very good.
Yeah, good. I could able to see many of the persons because seeing, speaking in front of the persons is always encouraging.
Yes.
Use the sound idea. So once again, good evening to everybody. So Shatabdi Club, as I said, I've come to the many of the events, programs, meetings, many of the club meetings I joined with all of you. This year also, previously also, when I started in this club also, I was there. I was one of the participants in that. And now also, in this year, in this COVID year, when Lion Durga Prasad has taken the charge for this club, in this critical situation, the challenging situation, so he is doing well, because that depends upon the circumstances. We are coming to the virtual things, because when problem or crisis arises, we take the new opportunities will come out. Because about 6 months back, 90% of the who are present here, they did not know about what is the virtual meeting, how to act according to that. But it has become very much familiar to all of us. We are joining very closely, friendly here, very easily, without wasting our time. Only the actual time we are sitting at home and doing the things. So like that, the club has taken up the initiative of taking all these health issues, connected to health issues, whatever it may be the COVID-19 reasons, and maybe diabetic or nutrition or this thing, or in future also, I hope we will do the connected programs, because one club, if it takes the one type of programs, always that gives the more good impression on the public, or even among the Lions clubs also. You are more connected with the health issues related. Otherwise, you can take it as a signature project for your club this year. It will be better for always for you and for the club. So you are giving the wonderful knowledge and awareness, knowing about our health, how to maintain the health, because when you are taken the first program, there was a lot of fear about the corona. Of course, here now also corona is more than that now, but we are mentally prepared now, because we are seeing it. At that time in the March, April, May, it was very difficult. There was a lot of phobia, but still it is there. The corona or the COVID-19, whatever we are saying, that is trapping us. That is trapping more people. Whatever the extra care we are taking, it is coming into our life. But we are able to mentally prepared for it. As we know, with all your experiences, seeing what you are seeing in the media or anywhere, the COVID that is not affecting much about most of 90% people. When they are affected also, they are surviving very easily mentally. They are, if they are strong, they are moving like that. But only few of the persons already they are connected with the health problems, health connected problems, they are going into the again serious problem and illness, and maybe leading to the sometimes death, to the death. But no, it's not for all the cases. That mental preparation has come during this process of these 6 months. So that is one way good sign. So until unless this vaccine comes, we can't do anything. We have to wait for it and we have to live like that according to this. And the senior citizens, all of us, we have to take care of that. And we know the precautions and even medical protocol for doctors also, it has come now. So they are using the different medicines that they are able to control. So why I'm telling is these things, particularly because everybody knowing about it, it is of positive thinking. We should have the good positive thinking. By that we can overcome the problems, overcome the crisis here what we are facing now. Previously in the world, we never had this type of problems. This is the first time we are facing it. If you go through this problem, if at least if you live like that in this year 2020, we can do again do the wonders in future. That we are our thinking. First of all, you have to the positive thinking. Why I'm telling positive thinking means, recently I've seen the one, I think everybody know about the actor Murali Mohan. Not only actor, he is a producer and realtor and is the most successful businessman. What he was telling about the, he failed in the politics because he lost 10 years of his life in the politics. That was not interested due to the pressure of the, some of the political leaders he had taken up, but he is not totally satisfied with that. Because now what we are telling is, I am old of 80 years now, but the 10 years I will take now, up to 90 years I will work in this other part of this political politics. Means he is so positive thinking. That positive thinking, at the age of 80 years, I can do many things in the even next 10 years means, that is called positive thinking. What I actually am very much was impressed with that the statement that what he was telling. Because at the 80 years of age of thinking of doing the many things, he has got some goals and targets to do that. Other than politics, means that the great personality, I can say mentally, is very strong. Like that we should also, even if you senior citizens are age of 50, 60, 70, 80 years also, you can also think about that in that lines. That is called positive thinking. Because our thinking makes a lot of difference. If you think positively, our attitude will also change. Our actions will also change. Our plans also will change. Even our health problems also will change. Sometimes our negative thinking only add many things to the these health problems. If you think positively, if you think of most of the happy moments of your life, what gives a happiness to you, if you think in that lines, naturally health will improve in a better way. So why I'm connecting this to this, our today's topic is, because the topic is the most expert doctor, Archana, she is going to take up, because I am not going to involve or interfere in that topic. That's not my intention. But here is this about regarding the physiotherapy, as Durga Prasadji was telling that, because we do not know much about that. Always we think about physiotherapy in terms of the curing of orthopedic problems. Always orthopedic problems connected, not to otherwise. But that is the our daily routine life in the health problems also, how it works out. Those things we have to learn here, because the physiotherapy is very, very important. I too heard in the recent times in some of the topics and the books also, but practically when he was speaking, I also will try to understand that how it will be useful, because of doing only walking, is it enough? Or if you do something else, and what are the problems arises in the end of this going the as a senior citizens also, how it could be helpful. So this is a very useful topic. Today the club has taken up one of the wonderful club, excellent club in the district, most active clubs in our districts, in the, out of over 100 clubs. In these virtual programs, many of you going to participate here. I hope this will benefit the lines and non-lines who are participating here. First, you think about what is positiveness, because here is the physiotherapy. You think, keep in mind, if you, for example, if you take yoga, yoga is good. If you are practicing, that's enough. But knowing the thing is not a good thing. Knowing is different and implementing is different. Because we'll learn yoga. If you practice, we'll get the benefit. If you don't practice, what is the purpose? It's no purpose. Like that physiotherapy also, if you practice, account to that, that will be useful for us, whatever it may be, you think positively towards the physiotherapy, and then we shall get the benefit of it. So thank you everybody of these Lions Club members, and again, once again, Durga Prasad Garu, and also Peri Nageshwar Rao Garu, giving the opportunity to come. My second time again, I'm coming as the chief guest in this program. Of course, this does not make much difference. I am ready to participate any number of times with this such type of good programs. So we are the Lions, we are here to serve the community, finally. So serving now is the physically is not possible, because Lions always to love to serve, but in the corona period it is difficult to go out, because we are doing in this awareness programs, we could do something at least coming 5-6 months. It is always better. I advise my Lions members to take up these programs and involve the many of the Lions and non-Lions in these programs. I wish you all the best. Once again, I thank you everybody for participating in this program. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, Dr. Prakash Rao Garu. COVID positive and physiotherapy. ఈ మూడింటి రిలేషన్ గురించి చాలా చక్కగా వివరించారు మీరు. థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ సార్. నౌ దిస్ ఈస్ ద టైమ్ టు డాక్టర్ అర్చన. ఐ రిక్వెస్ట్ హెర్ టు టాక్ ఆన్ ఫిజియోథెరపీ అండ్ గివ్ ఏ గుడ్ సజెషన్స్ అండ్ టు ఎడ్యుకేట్ అస్. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
థ్యాంక్ యూ.
Yes, Archana, you can be at ease. You can speak in both the languages. Most of them understand both. Okay?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I'm very happy here to be here and sharing my thoughts with everybody. So, as the topic says, I will just put on the.
Yeah.
Just give me a minute. Yeah.
You may need the slides, okay?
So, yeah. The previous slide, I will just come to that. 1 minute. Yeah. So, yes, that's the topic that I've chosen today. And give me screen. So just give me a minute. I'm just adjusting the screen.
Sure.
Yeah. Okay. There. So as the topic suggests, it is physiotherapy at home. The main reason of having this topic is, even our chief guest mentioned, that we should not restrict the advice and suggestions given by a physiotherapist just to the physiotherapy clinic. It has to come home. Like as he said, that yoga has to be implemented. The same way, whatever physiotherapy tips you get, whatever advices you get, you have to continue doing them at home. And that's where it will actually make a difference. So in this lockdown, we have realized that many of us, almost every one of us, has become aware of each other's roles in our lives, right? We were not aware of so many people, how they were helping us. So we have got aware of that first. And now we have also started doing activities of other activities which we usually did not do. So if the help is not there in the house, we have started doing the mopping, cleaning, and various other activities. Or the activities which we already were doing, we have just started doing that for a longer period of time. And definitely that will have some effect on our bodies, because our bodies are not used to it. So here I'm in general going to talk about how to look after ourselves and how to make use of our own body to keep ourselves healthy and fit. So the topic that I have, 1 minute, I'll just push it to the next one. Just a minute, I'm just... Okay, so no, the previous one, just a minute. The topics are, after this. Okay, so these are the topics that I'm going to be talking on. And they are posture, breathing exercises, relaxation, and overlooked advantages of an active lifestyle. So coming to the first, this thing, I will talk on the posture. So here in posture, what happens is it's very important for each one of us to have a near normal posture, which sometimes get affected because of our mood. If we are tired or if we are in a sad mood, depressed, so there is always slouching, a little bending down, drooping shoulders. If there is some pain, then our body does some trick movements and tries to cover up the try to support that part of our body. There are some tightnesses in our body because of which also we take up a wrong posture, and also a lack of awareness. So many times we are not even aware that we have got used to the wrong posture. So trying to get aware of all this and becoming as close, having a posture which is so close to a near normal posture will always help us to keep our body fit and use our body efficiently. It already has the energy. It already has the strength. So so the common areas that I will cover in this topic will be there is this slide which very clearly explains to us that how we need to look at some points which will just make us aware of what is the correct posture. So here we have where it shows that the chin should be parallel to the floor, the chest should be pushed forward, the ears are directly over your shoulder, then both the shoulders are braced behind, you open it, the belly button, it is pulled up so that the spine, the all the other curves of the spine are closest to the normal spine curvatures. Then we have to keep our knees relaxed, then our toes, they also need to be relaxed, and weight has to be spread equally on the entire foot, both the feet. The topics that I will be speaking very deeply on will be mainly the cervical area, the lower back area, how to look after that, and the knee joint. And I'll also explain a little bit about the breathing exercises and relaxation. So in the cervical area, what happens is most of the times we don't realize, but now that the screen time has increased and our work in the house has increased, we tend to protrude our chin. And when we are protruding our chin, the muscles at the back of the neck are working more than what they should be working. They go into fatigue and tiredness, and there is where we start experiencing the pain and spasm. There are also times when the using of the mobile or the laptop, the same thing happens. We try to hold our shoulders up. We are all the time working with the upper back muscles and the muscles at the back of the neck. Then they get into that fatigue mode. So here what we need to do is how we can take care of this is just the basic neck exercises, in which we need to keep our shoulders steady and complete the range of movement. So it is completing and looking completely to the right, where the chin is almost in line with your shoulder, to the left, come back to the center, look up towards the ceiling, come back to the center, and touch your chin on the chest, down and come back. So these are the, and also the diagonal exercises, where you look up to the right top and come down to the left, down, again, left top and come down to the right, down. So these are the exercises which are very simple. Everybody has told you, you must have always heard it from somebody. But the most important point over here is to perform them. And now that, as I said, the muscle gets fatigued because of our extra activities, do it regularly, every hourly. What another thing I always suggest is there is no need of circumduction, because we do not use this in any of our daily activities. We don't need this circumduction for any activity. As far as we are doing all this, our ranges are kept normal and we'll be able to look after our neck muscles. So even in the physiotherapy clinic, they sometimes suggest you that you can give pushes on the right, on the left, forward and back. So if any time, my suggestion to you is the best way to do this exercise is to lie down on the bed and keep two pillows on the sides and push with the neck. So here what advantage you get is your entire body is relaxed, and then you're only using the neck muscles, head and neck muscles. You're not using the body where you can just tilt and make a mistake when you're pushing the head on either sides. So you can keep two pillows, push it on the right side, hold for a few seconds, relax, turn on, complete the exercise on one side, then turn on the left side. Then also you can lie down on your stomach and push your head forward on the pillows, or keep the pillows behind and push your head back on that. So it, as I said, the advantage is your entire body is absolutely relaxed. Now, the other thing that I want to show is the trapezius muscle. Yeah, this is the trapezius muscle. This is a very important muscle because you can see that it expands from the back of your neck. Just a minute. From the back of your neck to the middle of your thorax. So this muscle is supporting all the activities that we are doing with our neck and shoulder girdle. So this is the muscle which will always, you will have this complaint of backache, it's the upper backache, it's because of this muscle going sore. Because so many activities, what we do, are all taken care of. The shoulder girdle is stabilized by this muscle, which is working all the time throughout the day. So it's very important to look after this muscle and take care. So what are the simple things that you can do is, one is the shoulder rotations, where you keep your fingers on your shoulders, join your elbows in front of you, raise them up, take them behind and pull them down completely and join the elbows in front. This is one motion. The other motion is you take it behind, take it up, bring it close and bring it down. So you can do 5 clockwise movements, 5 anti-clockwise movements. This really relaxes the big fan shaped trapezius muscle. So the other exercises where you need to brace your scapular bones, that is the bones which are over here. So the trapezius and the other muscles inside, all of them work together. You have to brace them back and pull them apart. It's a very relaxing, simple exercises which you can do at home. You don't need a physiotherapy clinic right now. It's difficult to go. So this is what you can continue doing at home. The next is, what you can do is have a pulley system in the home. So just look out for a point where you can pull up a rope or a dupatta or anything that goes around a pulley, and you can have all your shoulder exercises done there. Because along with the neck, you need to also exercise and keep your upper shoulder joints and the upper shoulder absolutely supple and in a healthy condition. What happens with this small gentle exercises is there is an increased blood supply. Increased blood supply clearly says that there is more oxygen reaching to the muscles, which is so important for nourishing the muscles. And when this is happening, simultaneously, all the pain factors are being driven away from the muscle. So when your muscle is healthy, it supports the spine properly. And when it's supporting the spine properly, there is very less wear and tear happening at the joints of your vertebral spine, the joints in the vertebrae. This is very important for us, because the way you will keep it healthier, the more you can use it without having any pain. So now the next one which I am taking care talking on is the lower back pain. So what happens is our lower back, usually this is the area where the maximum stress is there, and because we might be doing so much work in the house, where we are standing, we are sitting, we are kneeling and doing something, we are sitting on the chair for longer hours, or we are doing some mopping, and now in the lockdown more so, the work has increased where you have to do too many activities. So all the stress comes on the lower back. So muscles can get a little sore. And also what happens is, what we don't realize is that for the lower back, it is important that our muscles, abdominal muscles, which are the muscles which are above the navel and below the navel, they should not be weak. The muscles which are at the back in the lower back, they should not be weak. If they are weak, and if we are mostly standing with a forward tilt, then definitely the stress on the back is going to be there and the muscles will get fatigued. Also, we forget the importance of rotations at the spine. The complete rotations which happen at the spine because we are so involved in doing other activities, we don't realize that stretching a muscle always relaxes a muscle and also increases the blood supply to a muscle. So a simple thing like spinal rotation is missed out on. But of course, we can do that also. It is very simple, just to remember the what has to be done. Once you are aware, you will definitely put it in your daily habits. So one of the exercises, this static back exercises, where when you lie down on the bed, there is always this gap which we can feel. What we need to do is push our lower back down and flatten it. When we flatten this, the spine, the curvature, is the back is flattened and there is a posterior tilt at the pelvis, this area, the hip area. This helps to relax your lower back muscles. So this is a very simple thing you can do at home. You just have to lie down on a flat surface and push the back down so that the back is flat. This helps a lot in relieving the back pain, which is due to the muscle fatigue. Also, people who are following yoga, they will know that this is Pavan Muktasan, one of the asanas, which also again helps you to flatten the back, which is relaxing all the muscles which are around the lower back, which always are stressed because of our work. A few things that I want you to know, that the tips which can help to reduce the stress on the lower back, is how to lie down in the bed. So when you are lying down in the bed, the first thing you need to do is sit at the edge of the bed, put your arms on the bed in the sideline way, pull up your legs on the bed, and then slide and lie down. This is very important. Lying down on the bed in this way and getting up. When you get up, also turn on one side, push with your arms and push your legs down, and then get up. This reduces the stress on the lower back. These are very simple things, but they actually make a huge difference when there is a soreness in the muscles of your back. Other thing what you can do is, here you can see very clearly when you're lying down, if there is any discomfort in your lower back, always place a pillow in between your thighs. That helps again for relaxation, and also pillow below your thighs when you're sleeping on your back. Other thing what you can do is, when you feel the soreness, just relax. This is a very good way of you can see here very clearly that the back is absolutely flat. You can support it on a chair, on a poof, on a bed edge, anything that you are comfortable with. So this is one thing. These are a few things that you need to remember. Also, when you're standing and walking, this is what sometimes you can see that sometimes we are working in this posture. So here, the most important thing is to keep a footrest. You can see clearly that there is a footrest over here. You can keep a footrest and keep shifting the foot which you are keeping. First, you keep your right foot for some time, then you keep your left foot. This relaxes the back a lot. It keeps it, it's written over here, back with natural curve. So as close you can keep your curves to the natural posture, that much less strain there is on the back muscles. So there are a few other strengthening exercises that you can follow. And they are, here we can see that this is a Superman pose in normal words, or it's a Nokasan if anybody is following the yoga. And these are there is no equipment required. You just have to follow these exercises to strengthen all your back muscles, which help to keep you standing. And this is another pose, the bowl pose. And this helps to strengthen all your abdominal muscles and the muscles in the front side of your body. And then there is this planks. Again, you can see it's a thing absolutely doable. This is a very simple, in yoga, it is called Santolanasan. And in other words, the other name for it is planks. Everybody is aware of it. The question is when to start and how much to continue. Please do these exercises almost every day. They're very simple ones. They definitely can be done at home. Then we have the Tadasan. In Tadasan, make sure that you have raised yourself on the toes and you're holding your posture absolutely straight and up. Start with little things. Do it only for 5 seconds or 10 seconds. but definitely incorporate this, because all the body muscles are working over here and it's working beautifully on your balance, which is very important. So that is the thing about the back. One more thing which I want to definitely say over here is how you pick up weight from the floor. If you're picking up weight from the floor, when the back is sore, always bend at your knees. Make sure that you keep the weight close to your body. And at the sink when you're working, or you're working at any platform, never bend forward, because bending forward definitely increases the stress at the lower back. So keeping these points in mind, now we'll move on to the knee joint. Knee joint definitely is a very important joint. It is almost like a king of joints. So we need to take care of a knee joint. Here, I just want you to get familiar with the bones involved. These are the thigh bones. This is the thigh bone. Then this is the knee cap, which you feel at the knee joint. And these are the bones of your legs. Here is this. This is the actual knee joint cavity with this soft padding. And this is the one which takes a lot of stress when we are standing or not using the knee in proper way. So most important thing over here is how to take care of this knee. What things you can avoid when you are at home. This is something called an hyperextended knee. Sometimes we are not aware. As I said, lack of awareness can cause a little bit of problem. But once you are aware of it, you can make those changes. It's very easy. This is called hyperextended knee. This puts a lot of pressure on the knee joint cavity that you just saw. So this we definitely avoid if there is a knee pain. Other things which you need to avoid is squatting on the floor. You can easily avoid and do the same activities on a stool or a bed or something. If there is any prayer or anything, there is no need to sit down. It is okay to sit on a chair or stool and pray over there. Avoid cross sitting. Avoid squatting. Avoid lady sitting where you keep one leg over the other. All that puts a little bit of pressure on the knee joint. What we need to also remember is that when we are standing for longer hours, it definitely puts a lot of pressure. So what I had previously explained about the using the footrest, you can use that for your knees also. So, and the one very important thing which we always miss out, which we don't realize, is the footwear. The footwear, a very comfortable footwear, is a very important part of taking care of your knee and the lower back. Because the pressure distribution, if you don't have a good footwear and the arches are not strong of your feet, then the pressure distribution at the lower back and at the knee is going to actually cause stress on the knee joint and lower back. So it is completely okay if there is an element of pain in your knee or lower back. It is completely okay to wear some clean, nice, comfortable sportswear shoes in your house. It's absolutely fine for those days. You can definitely do that. Now for the knee, there are a few things that you can do for helping. So here you can see there is this knee contractions. Very simple things, but need to be done. If there is acute pain, they have to be done every hourly. You have to keep a small towel roll under the knee and just contract the knee joint on it. Push it down. When you're doing that, you're massaging the knee joint. Do this on both the sides always, on both the knees. Always remember, all the exercises do on both the sides, even if the other knee is not involved. Because when one knee is injured or is in pain, the other knee definitely takes over the work. And then slowly, that also gets fatigued. So this is patellar contractions, kneecap contractions. Very simple. Just keep a towel roll and push your knee down on it. Hold it for a contract for 5-6 seconds and gently release. The releasing part of the kneecap also needs to be very gentle. So do this on both the sides. It always helps. Then the patellar gliding. Now the kneecap gliding. You must have seen small kids. Sometimes they sit straight with the legs kept straight and they keep moving their kneecap on sideways and up and down. Bobbing the kneecap up and down. This might seem very funny and may not be of any use, but it is absolutely important because it always keeps the patella, the kneecap, free of any adhesions that are formed below that. Adhesions is some fluid which gets collected below the knee joint, in the below the kneecap, and that avoids the complete movement of the knee and also causes pain at the knee joint. So when you do that patella, moving the knee, the kneecap up and down and sideways, it always helps in nourishing the knee joint. And then there are also these exercises to help and develop the quadriceps, that is the main muscle at the on the top of the thigh. You can see here that the person is using a small towel roll over here. Now this is a very important part. Never miss out on the towel, because then it will help to keep your thigh straight and it will not go slanting down. Because otherwise, when you lift your leg up from this position to this, what happens is the thigh goes down a little bit. Then the whole purpose of doing this exercise is gone. So you can tie some very small weight or even without a weight, it is fine. But do this exercises of raising the knee joint, sitting very comfortably on a chair with a small towel under the knee. This definitely helps to increase the muscle strength, which is supporting your knee joint when you are standing, walking, climbing staircase, doing any activities. The next is trying to strengthen the muscle at the back of your knee. So you can comfortably lie down on the bed and then bend the knee towards your buttocks and straighten. This can be done with or without weights, depending on what you can take. Now, this exercise is best done when the upper body is completely relaxed, because then you have stabilized your hip joint on the bed and you're using only the hamstring muscles. I'm sure you must have heard of this muscle. This is the muscle which runs at the back of the knee, the hamstring muscles, and it really helps to strengthen it. So you can go on adding weight as and when you feel you're ready for it. But strengthening of these two muscles, the quadriceps, which are in the front of your thigh, and back of the thigh is the hamstrings. They are the ones which are going to majorly support your knee joint. And as I said about now this is a very important part now, more so that we are in the house and working at the desk. Everyone's screen time has increased. Everybody is on the laptop, either for the school reasons or whatever they are, university lectures or work from home. This is the way we need to sit on a chair. The ears are above the shoulders. The back is well supported. The arms are completely supported on some table or some rest. Very important. See, even the eyes have to be in line so that we don't keep jutting out our neck and we don't keep looking down. That's why the screen needs to be up at, in the level of your eyes. The thighs, the knees, and the foot need to be at right angles to each other. This is the best posture, because here the muscle is completely relaxed. Because if you are not in this posture, then the muscle is unnecessarily used and energy is wasted, which is absolutely not a very good thing. So the exercises that you need to do for your knee, never ignore, what I would like to say is never ignore your knee pain. If there is any indication of knee pain, definitely take rest. Another thing what you can do is you can raise your legs. Think that this is your foot, this is your knee joint, and this is your thigh. So support completely and keep the knee raised. This helps in reducing, pushing the, with the help of gravity, the swelling, extra swelling which is there in the knee, that gets pushed down. Then do the knee contractions, because then that helps like a pumping action. It will bring in the new blood. It will remove all the pain factors. Apply ice to your knee. If the pain is acute, it means you have just injured or just started realizing. So always apply ice, because that helps in reducing the swelling. And proper footwear, as I said, it is absolutely important for knee joint. Then now we have the breathing exercises. Because many of you must be doing yoga, or I must have attended some session where they have explained about their breathing, how important it is. And now in this COVID, I'm sure everybody has got introduced to oxygen saturation. What is oxygen saturation level and how it needs to be taken care of, and it is definitely important. But even after this phase gets over, it is important. And we have these beautiful lungs, which if we use to their entire capacity, they are enough to provide the oxygen required for your body. So in spite of knowing different types of pranayams and breathing exercises, something like this, which is very simple, it is called the pursed lip breathing. You can see here, the things that you need to remember in pursed lip breathing is that you have to inhale through your nostrils and you have to blow out through your mouth with the lips as if you are blowing on a candle. Another thing that you need to remember is the breathing in has to be shorter than the blowing out. Now, the importance of this blowing out slowly is that it creates a back pressure in your airways, which goes till the lower lobes of your lungs. So all the airways are kept open because of the back pressure. And it reaches the small sacs where the actual oxygen and carbon dioxide exchange is taking place. Now, if these pipes remain open, then we get the advantage when we are blowing out, we get the advantage of emptying our lungs of all the gases that are not required in our body, like the carbon dioxide and the various other gases. And the oxygen is able to reach till the lowest lobes of your lungs. So you can imagine how much exchange, how much of oxygen is going into your blood and how much richer your blood is getting of oxygen. And now that in the lockdown, our pollution has reduced. So definitely take advantage of this. Definitely do a deep breathing. If you are not aware of any other pranayam exercises, pranayams or any other breathing exercise, this is the simplest one to do, which you can do every hour. Because what happens is we are naturally inclined to shallow breathing. We are not even aware that we can breathe in so much and so much of oxygen can be supplied to our body. So simple thing, just inhale deeply through your nose, blow out through your mouth. The blowing out, the exhalation has to be much longer as if you are emptying your lungs. And then continue this once in an hour, about 4, 5 to 6 times, which is also sufficient. And now that if you have an oximeter, that will be an immediate indicator. You can see the saturation improves by doing this pursed lip breathing. Very important and very simple. So also what happens is it also reduces our respiratory rate. So people who are aware of pranayams, they will know the importance of a low breathing rate. Because it just slows down all the activities. A lot of wear and tear is reduced in our body and it always keeps our body healthy. So breathing, you can also combine with some of your movements that you do for your exercises. Like when you raise your hands up, inhale. When you bring your hands down, exhale. When you get your hands in front of you, exhale. When you open your chest, inhale. So it can be a combination also, a little more interesting. Okay, so now the most important thing is relaxation. This is ignored a lot because we always feel just by sitting on a chair we are relaxing, but that does not happen, because when you are sitting on a chair also there is some tone in your muscles, some contraction in your muscle to make you sit straight is always happening, but body needs to be relaxed. So many times we don't realize, but our forehead muscles are always tightened. As I said, more so in the increased screen time. The scalp muscles are tightened. All these lead to tiring of these muscles. And then we have a headache and we don't even realize that it is because of these small things. Tense shoulders. Then we also have the way we hold the mobile phones. Talking on the phones has increased. So posture while sitting on the couch, I explained to you, when you're sitting on the couch for all this binge watching and everything, we don't realize, but we sit in very awkward positions for a very long time. And it puts a lot of stress on the other muscles, which are trying to support that posture of yours. Then while we are typing and all, the hands remain up. This is called wrist extension and this is flexion. So the arm, hand remains up for a long time, and these muscles also get very tired. The muscles of your forearm get really tired. Also, when we are sitting or standing or working at the kitchen or wherever we are working, sometimes we try to hold the slipper or the floor very tightly with our toes. And our toes also go into a lot of tiredness. The screen time, increased screen time has increased the stress on our eyes. So very important to do something for all this. So it starts with something as simple as Shavasana. If you can perform this asana, that is just lying down and letting go. Here I've shown a picture where you have to just lie down for a few minutes. You can lie down on the floor or on your bed, anywhere that you are comfortable. And try to start from your toes and go on relaxing your toes, your ankle joints, your knee joints, your legs, thighs, and reach to the skull. Completely relax. The most important thing in Shavasana is not to fall off to sleep. The important thing about Shavasana is being aware of the relaxation that is taking place in your body. It is very important. You have to realize and be aware of the scalp relaxing, of the forehead relaxing, muscles around the eyes relaxing. Relaxing our jaw muscles. We don't realize. So many times it is just tight. And then we wonder what is it that is tiring us, that though we are not moving out of the house. So that definitely very important for our eyes is the basic eye exercises, which is just taking the eyeballs up and down, right, left, in cross, without any movement at your neck and head. It's a very beautiful, simple exercise, which you can do at any time of the day. It is fine. Another very important thing that you can do to relax your eyes is palming. Warm your palms nicely. In yoga, I'm sure you all must have done, but doing this every hour is very important. So warm your palms, place the warm palms on your eyes, and let your eyes relax in the darkness of the palm. This really helps to calm down the eyes and relax the small muscles which are around the eyes. That will remove a lot of your tiredness. Other one, which is very important now, is blinking. Our eyes are getting very dry because of lot of screen time. So blinking is very important. Every hour, just blink your eyes. That helps to keep the moisture intact, which is required on the outer layer of your eyes. Because that is what keeps your eyes healthy. That is nourishing your eyes. So that is about the relaxation, which I said. Also, there are little things which we are not doing if there is a complete lockdown, which we faced. I don't know. I'm hoping there won't be another one. But just that you should remember this thing. So I just want you to be aware of it. That is, when we are outside, we always walk on uneven grounds. And that does not happen when you are in the house because you are on a very flat platform. So one way to include this in the house is walk on a mattress. If you can place a mattress on the floor and walk on the mattress, you are then walking. It's very similar to walking on uneven ground. And it is also very important because it sends various stimulation to your cerebellum, the big brain and the small brain. And it is important for improving our balance. So we should not miss out on that. Step climbing, if you're fortunate enough, just even if you're not going out, just go to the staircase and climb up at least one staircase in a day. Traveling in a car or any vehicle, which we are not being able to do if we are in a lockdown. So in that case, what we need to do is, this traveling also is important because movement against direction, in all direction is also very important because it sends various information to our brain, which helps in keeping the balance intact. So for that, what we can do is walk straight with head like this, and the similar way, walk back. Don't turn around, just walk straight and walk back. Walk to the right, keeping the head straight only. Come back and walk to the left. And with this head only, with the head like this only, facing the center, go in circle. All these things are just a little simulation to the things that will happen when you're traveling in the in a vehicle. Then what is more very, very important is trunk rotations. It's very simple thing. Just turn back and look back whenever you can. Basic things which you can do whenever you're sitting on a chair, on a sofa, on a bed, anywhere. trunk rotations are very important because they work on the spinal muscles as well as the joints of your vertebrae. And this increases the blood supply to it, the nourishment to it, and reduces the wear and tear. You will see that, you know, it is so important, and you can see it in nature. When a cat or a dog is sitting for a long time, when they get up, they definitely stretch. They stretch themselves and then they get up. So this is our important stretching. Rotating, so rotate on both the sides and look behind. You can laterally bend on both the sides, right and left. This just works. Yeah, this just works on all the motions. These are the movements of your spine. So you have to use it. And then not to forget, what we are missing out is, of course, the cardiac exercises that I'm sure if you're doing a little bit of skipping or going up the staircase and doing other activities at the home, it will be taken care of. Most important, sunlight. We forget that being in the house has reduced our exposure to sunlight. So now if you get an opportunity, definitely go out, because this sunlight is going to help convert the dormant vitamin B in your body into active vitamin D, which is important for the calcium, which is required for your bones. So all of us, no matter what age group we are, we should get ourselves exposed to the sunlight. And now if the lockdown has got over and, you know, activities have started, make sure that you go in the sunlight and take that advantage for you. Other now, the last thing that I want to say over here is, any questions anybody has, please come forth with that. One thing I want to say over here is, all these healthcare systems that you have witnessed in the last few days, they all are something like a Bhagavad Gita book. Solutions to how you have to take solutions to, you know, to your problems in life. So all these healthcare systems are like that. It is for the Arjun to decide what he needs. So we have such a plethora of all these healthcare systems. Dr. Ambika Nair, Dr. Usha Rani, everybody told us the same thing, that exercises are important, taking care of our diet is important. Whatever knowledge is there, make use of it. Make it a way of life. There are so many ways which we can be at home and yet utilize and make our lives much more easier. All we need to do is be aware of it and utilize it. Like our chief guest said, implement it. A very important sentence. So thank you very much. Now I think we can keep it open for questions.
Yeah, you can close this call. Archana, close the screen. Then we'll have the questions.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Anybody has questions? Now it is open.
Somebody's talking.
You are mute. You have to unmute.
No, I can't hear. You have to unmute. There's a speaker.
You unmute, Nirmala.
It is enabled for everyone, so you can just unmute yourself and you can speak.
Archana, Dr. Archana, thank you so much for the information. Right. Especially in this corona time, all are staying at home.
Right.
And till last month, everyone are scared about the corona, but now they are used to it a little bit. They know that they have to live with that.
Exactly.
And I do yoga regularly. It helps a lot.
Absolutely, I'm sure.
It helps a lot. One more thing is, especially the women, when they take the vegetables from the fridge outside, which I noticed it, they literally go inside the fridge because they don't know what to cook every day, right? So that posture, especially the women should change, then it will be their leg pain and the body, like back structure.
Lower back, yes. Right, right.
And what you said, all the things are very important. Yes, we will follow that.
Yeah, because
thank you so much.
Thank you. Lower back, you have to take care of it. There are so many activities, as I explained, and you will know. When you sit back and just think, you will realize that, okay, I was doing this. Most importantly, once you get aware of it, make use of the advices and tips that are given to you by any healthcare professional.
Yeah.
Praveen, can we unmute the members because they are writing that they are not able to unmute themselves?
I have given an option, sir. Everybody can just unmute themselves and speak now.
Mr. P.S.N. Murthy has a question.
Yeah, P.S.N. Murthy.
Hanji, have few questions?
Yes.
They can come up with the questions. Or if he wants to address there is some message that is
BSN Murthy.
Yeah, please sir, you can try to unmute and speak.
I got it. Yeah, thank you.
Please ask Murthy.
Yeah, Dr. Arsana Garu, a very wonderful session. A lot of information you have shared. I have a few questions, but in case time permits, you can answer. Otherwise, a few questions I have. The first question is on walking. Because generally, because looking at this COVID and other aspects also, we do walking within our premises.
Right.
And the surface is very hard.
Right.
What are the precautions we have to take on this hard surface? Because it is very difficult to find very soft ground where we can do walking.
This is an excellent question. Excellent. So my advice.
One more question related to this itself is how the step to be landed.
How?
Because our steps while walking, landing is very important, because generally what we do when we land our steps, it lands on the ankle.
Yes.
That's impacts of knee. There I want your tips. That is question number one. The second question is, what should be the pace of doing exercise? When we do exercise, what should be the pace? Whether the pace is related to the age, whether there is any pace we should maintain while doing the exercise. This is question number two. The other question is, while getting up in the morning, early in the morning, like that, or we have the body on the bed itself and to get up? These are the three questions I have.
The last question, sorry, I did not get it. There was a disturbance. Can you please?
While getting up, I think.
Getting up?
Yeah, while getting up in the early in the morning. What are the processes we have to take? Can we get up directly from the bed, or we have to stretch our body? Yeah, that is these three questions.
Excellent. So the first one was walking on hard surface. So what I would advise is having a very good footwear.
Okay.
It is very important, because you will face this hard surface most of the time. So it is very important that we wear a good footwear, because only that will have lesser impact on our knees and our lower back. So if you are able to find a good footwear, it will always be good. It will be always nice. Then also coming down a staircase. I think that was the second question.
Second question was the landing, ma'am. While doing the walking, generally we walk it. How the step should land? The step should land on the toes, or step should land on the ankle?
Heels, always on the heel.
Okay.
Always heel. The heel will come first, and then the foot will come down.
Okay.
That is the correct way, because then the pressure gets distributed evenly up to the body. So
heel and toes.
No, the heel is very important.
Okay.
Yeah. And the question after that was, what do you do when you get up? Now there is a very beautiful thing, very simple things that you need to do when you are getting up. First is curl your toes, then do the ankle toe movement, stretch it completely down the ankle, pull it up completely, do rotations of your ankle in both the directions,
okay,
yeah, then as I explained previously, turn on one side, put your legs down, push with your hand and come up to sitting. Once you come up to sitting, again do your ankle toe movements. This ankle toe movements causes the calf muscles to contract, which is like the second heart of your body. So it is pushing all the blood back to the head, and it will immediately make you alert. You know, it is putting all the stagnant blood through the night, which has got stagnated in your legs. It will be sent up in circulation. That is one thing. And the shoulder rotations, which I explained. If you do this, there is a carotid plexus over here, which senses the movement and it makes the brain alert. It sends the blood circulation to the head. and helps to increase our breathing, and immediately we are alert and ready for the day. But I will also say one thing over here. The ankle toe movements and the curling of toes and the stretching of toes is the most beautiful relaxing exercise. If you do it for your feet before sleeping or whenever you feel tired, immediately your tiredness will be gone. It is like acupuncture or acupressure does on feet. It's a very good thing to do, very simple. Curl toes, take your ankles up and down, do rotations of your ankles. Very simple, hardly takes any time. I hope I've answered the question.
Yes. One more question is missed. The pace of the exercise that you missed out.
Yes, pace of the exercise. Now, any exercise that you're doing, it should not tire you out. So when you start, this is a very important measure. So if you are getting exhausted with an exercise, that means you are overdoing it. It's a very simple thing, because otherwise there is no gadget which can tell you, okay, this is what you have to do. Always remember, your normal is your normal. Anybody else's normal is their normal. So the comparison is not with anybody else. It is only with you. If you are getting exhausted, you are getting breathless, that means somewhere we are going wrong. After doing an exercise, you have to feel refreshed and good and energized. If you are feeling exhausted and tired, slow down. It is okay. As Dr. Ambika Nair said, 45 minutes of exercise, a brilliant idea. But if somebody is not being able to do it, start with 5 minutes. Start with 10 minutes. Do some basic PE exercises. Remember the school PE exercises. Do some basic things, but begin slowly. It's always good to slow down rather than tire and exhaust yourself.
Thank you, Doctor.
Yes? Thank Dr. Achal, this is Narayan Rao. I have a question for you.
Please tell me.
Suppose somebody has got knee pain. Do you suggest or do you recommend their walking?
Yes. Actually, there is no... First of all, we have to understand the cause of knee pain. If it is just a little bit of swelling or something that has not yet brought in the deterioration of the knee joint, then walking is absolutely all right with a very good footwear, as I previously also mentioned. Walking with a proper footwear is very good. And when you have this kind of pain, what I previously suggested, keeping the knee raised in slant so that there is draining of the excess fluid in the knee joint, the contractions of the knee joint, the patellar cap, the knee cap, contraction of that, applying ice, all this will help to take care of your knee pain. And never ignore knee pain. Footwear, please remember that the footwear has to be correct if you decide to walk. And as I explained previously, how much will you walk? So decide to take only few steps, because see, walking has other many benefits to the body. So you cannot stop walking. So you can walk only in the house for few steps and then sit down and relax. When you're relaxing, the foot has to be completely on the floor and the knee and the thigh has to be at right angle. Then it is completely relaxed. Or you can sit with legs stretched out and relax your knees absolutely.
Second thing, do you suggest walking by barefoot, or some people recommend that walking with barefoot is also good?
Absolutely. Walking with barefoot is good if you are not on uneven surfaces and if you are not on slopes. Then your foot, and also very important thing over here to understand is your foot arches. The arches in your feet have to be strong. Then walking barefoot is a good idea. But if your arches are weak, then they are not going to spread the weight properly on your knee. And the foot might turn inwards and cause problem at the knee joint. Then you need the corrective footwear. If your foot is strong, then walking barefoot is always good. There is no problem. Yeah?
Thank you, Dr. Achal.
Now, Lakshmi Narasimha, he raised his hand.
Yeah. Yes.
I think.
Lakshmi Narasimha.
He's still on mute.
Yeah.
Somebody.
He's on mute.
Haji, somebody needs to help him.
Chitra Prasad. Yes, Chitra. Chitra, you can speak. Chitra, you can speak. Unmute and speak.
Yeah. Good morning. Good evening, ma'am. It's your, I am calling from Chennai. Actually, this points which you gave about the yoga is fantastic, that exercises. I have only one doubt that when I can do the exercise. You told about the morning relaxation and the other one, the remaining one, cough muscle one, remaining one. Whenever I'm free, I can do it, or is it a time limit that stomach should be empty or after? Is it something like that?
No, this is, you're talking only about the ankle toe movements? Is it only
not that you told me that it is the morning after you got up.
Haji.
Yeah, the remaining ones, like your foot exercises, that is hamstring exercises and other exercises which you told, then I should do it.
Okay. So one thing you have to remember, that
exercises. Somebody's
Can you hear me?
Second phone ever they get on the off chain, please.
No, somebody is switched off.
Somebody is also talking.
Hello.
Can you hear me, Chitraji?
Yes. Now I can hear you.
Yeah. So you allot a time. See, one very important thing is we have always been taught in school and everywhere that on a full stomach you cannot do any exercises, right? So either you do it in the morning. So that you have just had some basic water and maybe dates or whatever your morning routine is, where your stomach is comparatively empty. And or in the evening at around 4 o'clock you can do. Okay. And as I said, you start with few exercises, see how you're feeling about it. And then gradually you can increase. One by one you can go on increasing. Definitely on a full stomach, you cannot do this exercise.
Do it. Okay. You know, what I was thinking is whenever I'm having the leg pain, normally you will have the leg pain in the night after doing it, when you're relaxing. Can I do the hamstring that time? Will it be helping me there?
Yes, you can do that. You can do the ankle toe movements, the contraction of the knee.
Yes.
Contracting of the knee, the curling of the toes. All that will rejuvenate you. You know, these exercises relax the body. Why you feel it in the night is because all your attention from your daily work is gone. Now there is nothing else for the mind to think about. And that is where the mind becomes more sensitive to the pain that is in the body.
So, as I said,
it is very important to relax. So that's why I said relaxation is something which is majorly ignored by us. So in a daytime, if you go into relaxation for at least 3 to 4 minutes, go into complete shavasana, go and lie down on the bed through the day. Do it 2-3 times. You will not feel this pain in the night. Automatically, it will reduce. What happens is our body just doesn't get chance to relax. We feel leaving our work is being selfish, but no, it's not that way. You have to rest, rejuvenate. Then in the night also, there will not be so much pain. You will not realize it.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Nice of you.
Madam, I have a question, madam. Just Sridhar here.
Yes.
Yeah. So, recently I met a small minor accident, but nothing major happened. But what happened, I was comfortable for the first 15-20 days. And all the wound, whatever happened on the top, is everything cured. But suddenly I started going to office. I went twice. Okay. So, I think there's a stress put on the knee. So suddenly I got a knee. Suddenly I got a swelling and a pain. So I went to hospital also. They have taken x-ray and they have told a 10 days rest. Even though 10 days rest already, this last 2 days I completed my 10 days rest. But still I feel that pain. And also whenever I sit in a single direction, like if I sit most of the time in the chair for half an hour or 1 hour, and immediately if I want to move my leg, I'll get a pain. Otherwise, if I sleep and keep my leg straight, if I want to move again, it is get a pain. So do you have any specific exercise for that? And what is the best solution?
Correct. So you have fallen on your knee.
Yes.
Then fallen on your knee. Did you fall on your knee? Okay. So that is
impact
at the knee joint. Correct. So what happens is there
is
small
impact. They said some pressure. Yeah. They said there was a pressure when you fall on the knee, there's a pressure taken on your bone. So you have to take rest. That is what they mentioned when I went to the hospital.
They are right. What happens is because of that impact, there is some extra fluid that comes in your knee joint to do the healing and repairing. And some blood splits into the knee joint. Ideally, there is not supposed to be any blood joint. See, this is the way of blood in the knee joint. this is the way how our body heals. But what happens is, what you need to do, Sridharji, is you need to start doing that knee contraction. Just resting the knee will not be a solution. So you contract the knee cap. You hold that tight, which you saw, that towel roll, small towel roll kept below the knee. So when you're sitting in long sitting, you do the knee contractions on that, hold it for 5 seconds and release gently. That is one you need to do. Then you do need to do the knee raising, which will help to drain the excess fluid. Then apply ice. Apply ice and then again do the knee contractions. These things, once the swelling is gone, automatically your pain will reduce.
Yeah.
A gentle movement, gentle bending of the knee without any weight. Don't apply weight. And the quadriceps exercise, which I told you, where the knee is like this, you straighten it and you put, take it down. The gentle exercise is that. And the when you are lying down on your stomach and bending your knee, that. These gentle exercises you must do. You can, we cannot keep the joint immobilized. If we keep immobilized, then that extra fluid that collects in our knees, it freezes like how ghee freezes. And then it causes more pain. So do little movements. Do little movements. Wear a good footwear. Do the knee contractions. Apply ice. These things, if you do, I'm sure the pain will reduce.
Okay. So thank you very much.
Important, but you should not stress it. That is what is very important.
Yeah, that is the reason. That's sometimes I'm wantedly stressing how it actually. Sometimes the pain is coming, sometimes not coming. What is the reason why it is coming? I have to understand.
Correct. So and every time your foot, every time your knee is immobilized, there is no movement. The fluid starts collecting in the knee joint. So that's got why it, when the first movement you do, you feel that pain because of that excess fluid that has got collected. So if you do the knee contractions and then bend your knee, then you will not feel the pain because it has drained and new blood has come. Yes.
Thank you very much.
Dr. Chan, another question. How do you define good footwear?
Pardon me?
How do you define a good footwear?
Yeah, good footwear. Yes, this is a very, this is a very important thing. So what happens is, when you, whenever you go to see a footwear, whenever you go to buy a footwear, always remember that the it has to in on the inner edge of the footwear, on the inner edge, that is when you are looking at your foot, the inner edge, there is an arch. So there has to be something that very nicely supporting that arch. If the footwear has that arch which keeps your foot in a proper angle and not flat, your foot size has to be, the size of your footwear has to be your exact foot size. Don't go in for a bigger size or a smaller size for any reason. If the toes have to be completely relaxed. When you stand up wearing the new foot, the new shoe, and when you stand up, the toes should have enough space to relax. They cannot be tight and crunched, or they cannot be flat and, you know, spread completely. So you will be able to sense it. And when, so any footwear which is like that is a good footwear for you. And please understand that after wearing that footwear, when you walk, you will not feel tired. If you are feeling tired, then definitely that is wrong footwear. Very sorry to say, but you will have to give it away or give it to somebody who fits in it properly and buy a new one.
So that is an indication.
That's an important thing to do for your foot, feet and knees.
That's an indication. Okay, thank you.
Hanji. Now, Lakshmi Narsiha, he has raised his hand.
Hanji.
Now, Durga Prasad. Durga Prasad.
You have to unmute Durga Prasad Garu. Yeah. Just before Durga Prasad Garu, I am Prakash Rao here.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. First of all, I congratulate the Durga Prasad Garu and Nageshwara Garu bringing the so excellently explained doctor. She explained everything connectivity with the all problems, connecting all the problems, and also question answer session also. I'm just enjoying how she is explaining that, because I was in the teaching profession. As a trainer also, I'm seeing it. She's well explaining it. And many points also, most of the solutions have also come for the different persons. And one point here is the barefoot is always good, doctor was telling. Barefoot on the road, is it possible?
So So what I'm trying to explain here is your foot arches, if they are proper, then barefoot anywhere is absolutely fine. But your feet need to be really strong for that. If your feet muscles are weak, if somebody's feet muscles are weak and they cannot hold the arches, because the proper arches, the biodynamics of the body changes. With the proper arches, the proper distribution of weight takes place. Then it is fine. Then it is absolutely fine to be bare feet. There is no problem at all. But
so most of some other problems, not these problems, and some other problems may come other than the orthopedic related.
Yes, that might not be clean. Absolutely.
Arjuna, one final question. Somebody wants to know what tips you can give them for running marathon of 5 kilometers, 10 kilometers and 20 kilometers.
So here I would like to say, first you see whether you have been trained. It is very important to be trained for running any type of marathon. Oh. And it does not see, nowadays people want instant results. Today they decide for a marathon and tomorrow they want to go for it. But it is not the right thing to do. Your body has to be absolutely compatible to take the load of that marathon. Marathon is not an easy thing. It is going to have impact on your entire body, your mental and physical state. So preparing for that, your cardiovascular system has to be that strong to meet the demands of the muscles. When there is an increased demand of oxygen or nourishment, your body has to be compatible with all that. So go through a proper process. If you decide to have a marathon after 1 year, start it today. Go to a proper expert who's going to train you properly. Flexibility. I always say a flexible body is more important. That is what we see in motorbikes. If you are seeing for proper absorbers in motorbikes, then it's most important to be in our body. So be very flexible first. Make sure you're flexible. Your cardiovascular system is properly trained. Your musculoskeletal system, muscles and the skeleton, get it checked. Whether if osteoarthritis has started, anything has started, go slow. Then you can do other things. Marathon, yes, if you are absolutely healthy for it and absolutely trained, then go in for a marathon. No problem at all.
Doctor, this question was posed by me. Only one clarification in this. There were, I do a regular walking of 5 to 6 kilometers, brisk walk I'm doing. Yes. And other aspects also taking into consideration that fitness of my body and other aspects I consider. And is it mandatory that I should go to a trainer and get trained and participate marathon? Because I already participated twice without going to a trainer. And now I'm 55 years. What do you recommend? Whether a trainer is a must or...
So in this case, if you have already had the marathon twice, if you have run marathon twice and you are comfortable, as I always say, you can be your own judge. If you are comfortable, there is no problem. But a very good idea is to just get your basic parameters checked from some physician, some doctor who knows you for a very long time. Because that person will exactly tell you where you stand and whether you should continue.
Sure.
And that will, I'm sure, always be an honest opinion, because your physician, whoever is your physician for a very long time, he knows your body parameters very well. So he knows whether you are in the comfort zone or not. And then you can continue, because you've already been doing it for 2 marathons, you've already done it. So you know how to get trained. You're on the right path. It's just a checklist. It's like just a checkpoint. You check it, you see whether you're proper, a green signal from your physician, go ahead with it. No problem.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Yeah, I think we are running out of time. I request Nagesh Rao to quickly sum up in Telugu for the benefit of people who have been waiting, so that we can close the program. Nagesh Rao.
Thank you. Thank you, Durga Prasad. Thank you very much, Dr. Archana. Asala manishi annatundi vaadu kurchinetappudu etla kurchovali, ye posture tho kurchovali, alage ninchunetappudu kuda ela ninchovali, steps ekketappudu ela ekkali, steps digetappudu ela digali, alage lockdown period lo pratyekinchi work from home chestunnatundi vaallandarki kuda oka manchi advice icharu avida, kurchilo entha sepu ela kurchovali, a back pain raakunda annatundi. Alage software engineers andaru kuda vaallu system operate chestunnappudu వాళ్ళ హ్యాండ్స్ ఎలా ఉండాలి, వాళ్ళ మూమెంట్స్ ఎలా ఉండాలి అన్నటువంటి విషయాలు, అలాగే కాకుండా నిత్యం మనం చేస్తున్నటువంటి యోగా అది సన్ లైట్ లో కనుక చేసినట్లయితే సన్ రైజ్ లో కనుక చేసినట్లయితే మార్నింగ్ ఎంత బాగుంటుంది అన్నటువంటి దాని గురించి కూడా చాలా చక్కగా వివరించడం జరిగింది. అలాగే ప్రత్యేకించి సీనియర్ సిటిజన్స్ అందరికీ కూడా ఒక చిన్న విజ్ఞప్తి, రాత్రిపూట ఉలిక్కిపడి లేవకంటే మంచం మించి సడన్ గా ఏదైనా ఒక ఫోన్ కాల్ వచ్చినట్లయితే మిడ్ నైట్ ఏం వచ్చిందో అనుకుని హడావిడి పడి లేస్తుంటారు. అలాగే వాళ్ళు వాష్రూమ్ కి వెళ్ళటం కోసం కూడా సడన్ గా లేవకండి. మీరు పడుకునేటప్పుడు మీ యొక్క మెదడు కూడా పడుకుంటుంది, అంటే అది ఒక లైవ్ లోకి రావాలి అనుకున్నట్లయితే ఇట్ టేక్స్ 2 to 3 minutes. కాబట్టి మీరు లేచి కూర్చుని దిగిన తర్వాత రండి, ఎందుకంటే మనం బాత్రూమ్ డెత్స్ చాలా చూస్తున్నాం ఈ మధ్య కాలంలో. ఒక అద్భుతమైనటువంటి ఈ సెమినార్ కి డాక్టర్ అర్చన చాలా మంచి సూచనలు ఇచ్చారు. ఆవిడ ఇంటి దగ్గర హోమ్, ఇంటి దగ్గర చేయాల్సినటువంటి ఫిజియోథెరపీ గురించి, అలాగే కోవిడ్ రిలేటెడ్ కి సంబంధించినటువంటి ఈ శ్వాస ఎలా తీసుకోవాలి అనేటువంటి దాని గురించి కూడా చాలా చక్కటి సెమినార్ మనకి ఇవ్వడం జరిగింది. అలాగే ఈ పార్టిసిపెంట్స్ అడిగినటువంటి క్వశ్చన్స్ అన్నిటికీ కూడా చాలా చక్కటి ఆన్సర్ ఇవ్వడం జరిగింది. ప్రతి సంవత్సరం కూడా మేము ఇలాగే ఇన్వైట్ చేస్తుంటాం లయన్స్ క్లబ్ ఆఫ్ హైదరాబాద్ శతాబ్ది తరఫున. థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ పార్టిసిపెంట్స్ అందరూ కూడా. నౌ దిస్ ఈస్ ద టైమ్ ఫర్ ఓట్ ఆఫ్ థ్యాంక్స్. ఐ రిక్వెస్ట్ లయన్ డాక్టర్ ఏఎస్ దుర్గా ప్రసాద్, ప్లీజ్ ప్రెజెంట్ ఓట్ ఆఫ్ థ్యాంక్స్.
Thank you, Naishwar Rao. First, let me thank you, thank our chief guest, Prakash Rao Garu. Not only that, he has given a very good address, very briefly, but also sat through the whole session and then admired us. Thank you very much, sir, for your time. Our heartfelt thanks to Archana. I think she was very much concerned that how this program will go. Probably this is your first webinar, Archana, is that right?
Yes, yes. Yes,
yeah, but I think wonderful. You did wonderfully well, and I think everybody enjoyed your talk. It was very curt, and then explanations were so good with visuals. I think it has appealed to everyone who has come over here today. I think at one time we had about 42 participants, and then because of the net problem here and then, but I'm sure that you have given us a very, very good insight and simple tips, which normally in our regular routine we miss out. So thank you very much for your time and also for that excellent presentation. I also thank Praveen for providing us with the technical support as always, and all other members who have taken it. I think last 3 weeks continue, at least for last 1.5 months, we have putting lot of pressure on the members to come and then listen to people, and then they have been patiently coming and then listening, sitting in front of their either mobiles or iPads or laptops. Thank you very much, and then I think it's time for us to raise for the national anthem.
Yes, national anthem with chorus. I request all of you please stand up.
Yes.
Yeah. Start national.
Start national. పంజాబ్ సింధ్ గుజరాత్ మరాఠా ద్రావిడ ఉత్కళ వంగా వింధ్య హిమాచల యమునా గంగా ఉత్కళ జలధి తరంగా తవ శుభ నామే జాగే తవ శుభ ఆశిష మాగే కాహే తవ జయ గాథా జన గణ మంగళదాయక జయ హే భారత భాగ్య విధాతా జయ హే జయ హే జయ హే జయ 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 హే
Durga Prasad, meeting adjourned.
The meeting is adjourned. Thank you.
Thank you, Durga Prasad, for an excellent. Thank you, Praveen Garu.
Sir, thank you, and congratulations for the wonderful session one more time.
Congratulations, Durga Prasad Garu and Nageshwar Rao Garu.
Thank you, Sridhar Garu. Ela unnaru?
Fine, sir. Fine. I'm in a rest. ఇలా ఎక్కువసేపు కూర్చుంటే పెయిన్ స్టార్ట్ అయిపోతుంది మళ్ళీ, అది ప్రాబ్లమ్. సో ఐ గాట్ సొల్యూషన్. ఐ థింక్ లెట్ మీ డూ.
Yes, very good, sir. Very good, sir.
Thank you,
Nagbabu ప్రసాద్ మాయ, చాలా బాగుంది, వెరీ యూస్ఫుల్, చాలా టిప్స్ చాలా బాగున్నాయి. థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్.
థ్యాంక్ యూ సీత, చూసా ఫస్ట్,
వెరీ నైస్ సెషన్, చాలా బాగుంది. ఇట్స్ గుడ్ చాలా మంచి యూజ్ఫుల్ సెషన్ ఇది చాలా చాలా బాగుంది థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్
చాలా యూస్ఫుల్ గా ఉంది థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్
చాలా యూస్ఫుల్ సెషన్ థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్ ఫర్ గివింగ్ దిస్ ఆపర్చునిటీ థ్యాంక్ యూ
ఆ విషయంలో
థ్యాంక్ యూ వైండాల్ సో ఐ యామ్ క్లోజింగ్ ది మీటింగ్ సర్
Yes, thank you very much, Praveen Gar, once again.